Welcome from my side, from Merck Millipore Darmstadt, Germany, and EMD Millipore for North America. I will talk about the multiple and fast and easy possibilities for disinfection control today. I will go into detail for different disinfectants, different examples, and also how to control them afterwards with very easy and fast methods. Okay, then let's start with the presentation. Here are different examples for disinfectants with typical application areas. Disinfectants normally should kill unwanted microorganisms in water, and we have different types of disinfectants, and all of them have different advantages and disadvantages, and I will tell you more details during the presentation about this. Here are three examples. One is peracetic acid, which is, for example, used for disinfect filling equipment in breweries, to disinfect also big 5-gallon bottles for drinking water. And the second example is glutathialdehyde, which is a disinfectant for pipelines or for production. And also peroxide, which is mainly used in food and beverage industries. Okay, and yeah, why to control the disinfectants? We have to control it when we use the disinfectant for the cleaning, because the agent has to be, the concentration has to be high enough to be really effective, yeah, to have really a contact with all the microorganisms that they have to kill, and also after the cleaning process. It has to be efficiently removed from the production equipment, and otherwise, yeah, in the food or in the beverage, you will have the residues left, yeah. They taste, you can taste it or you can smell it, and you don't want to have something left from the disinfectant agent. Okay, then I step into the different disinfectant agents that are commonly used. First example is the peracetic acid, and this is also used in food and beverage industry. You see here two pictures. So for drinking water bottles, they are often disinfected with peracetic acid. And also this 5-gallon bottles, as I already mentioned, and also for surface disinfection in production facilities. The determination of peracetic acid, yeah, there are two different possibilities. One which is really time consuming and you need a lot of glassware. It's the titration method. Maybe some of you know this titration method, and I just put here on the left side that there are different reagents used. They are all available from Merck Millipore or EMD Millipore, I didn't put the article numbers there, but they are available, but you need a lot of glassware, and that's why there is another solution available with a simple test strip. Yeah, you just take a test strip, dip it briefly into the solution, into your water sample, and then you just read off the color scale. And then you will find the corresponding concentration. Please keep in mind that this is a semi-quantitative result. Yeah, it's a visual comparison, and it's not a real quantitative result in this case. If you want to have a quantitative result, if you prefer that, and if you want to have a documented result, then we offer also a small instrument that can read off the test strips for you. That means you have on the screen a result, so a digital value that is on the screen. And as you can see, in 4 steps, it's very easy to use. And you also dip in just a small test strip into the water solution and then put it into the instrument, press a key, and you read off the result, and you have it ready for your documentation. Here are the different graduations of of mQuant are shown. Yeah. So as you can see, the you read off 0 or 5 or 10 milligram per liter per acetic acid. So this is the graduation, but if you really need a quantitative result where you can read the value of the screen, then you better use the reflectoquant system where you are in this range or with the other tests or in this range.